Good morning. Good morning. Welcome to our worship here at First Congregational Church of Washington. And I'm excited to be able to say welcome to our Zoom friends because it was a little dicey there today, this weekend, of whether we would be able to do that. But we're here. Everyone's here. The Wi-Fi is working. And so welcome to you. If you are male or female or a little bit of each, LGBTQ or straight or a little bit of each, have ancestors of one color or many colors or a little bit of each, are old or young or a little bit of each, rich or poor or a little bit of each, doubting or believing or a little bit of each, member or visitor or a little bit of each, immigrant or citizen or a little bit of each, have an able body or a disabled body or a little bit of each, in recovery or recovered or a little bit of each, in person or online or a little bit of each, no matter who you are, or where you are in life's journey. If you know it, say it with me. You are welcome here. And we are so glad that you are here this morning. And so as we gather in this space together, let's take a moment to feel ourselves in our seats, feel our feet on the floor, and take a moment to breathe. Breathe in the spirit who dwells among us. Breathe in life. Breathe out death. Breathe out a spider. Breathe in spirit. Breathe out numbness. Breathe in awareness. Breathe out neglect. Breathe in connection. Breathe out detachment. Thank you.
Carol Glintenkamp was scheduled to be our reader today. She's not feeling well. So let's pray that she is well very soon. Please join in our call to worship printed in the bulletin. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in times of trouble. We will not fear, though the earth should change, though the mountains fall into the sea. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in times of trouble. We will not fear, though the waters roar and roar, though the mountains tremble. Come, behold the works of our God. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Please join in singing hymn number 460, Holy God, we praise your name, standing as you are able. Please join in the invocation printed in Jim Bolton. God of us all, help us to remember there is no day but today, and that today is a gift. Remind us to measure each year, not in minutes, but in love. May this time together bring us closer to you by slowing down, by opening up, and by being present to this very moment. Guide us to let go of worry, so that we hear your word and be moved to share your love for the next 525,600 minutes and always. Amen.
I'd like to invite the children to come forward. How you guys doing? Good, good. No Bree today? She's slacking? Oh, wow, of course. Hey, you guys, come on up. How are you guys doing? Good? You guys know what this is? The calendar. Do you know what you use it for? To know what we're doing on days, yeah. Do you know how many days there are in a month, roughly? This one has 31, yeah. Some have 30, special one is 28 or 29. Do you know how many days are in a year? 365, yeah. Well, there was a giveaway, we just had a giveaway. Do you know how many minutes there are in a year? Yeah, 525,600 minutes. That's a big number, isn't it? Yeah, yeah. So when you use a calendar, you just mark the days, right? It's like, oh, there's this day and there's Sunday and we have church and Sunday school and maybe Monday we have school or not. But what if we measured time in a different way? What if we measured it in hugs? Do you know how many hugs you got yesterday? Yeah, that's cool. Do you know how many times you laughed yesterday? Awesome. Do you know how many times maybe somebody made you sad yesterday? You are on top of it, dude. I am jealous. So maybe instead of, I mean, it's important to know what day it is, right? Because we have stuff to do and things to happen. But what if we paid attention more to how we interacted with folks, like the people that made us laugh or the times that we made somebody else laugh? Because you like to laugh, right? I like to laugh. And I like it when people make me feel good too, right? So what if we measure time that way in laughter and love and hugs and high fives? And how about that? Maybe we should do that this week, okay? I mean, we still got to know what day it is because we have things and stuff. But what if we measure each day and how many times we held somebody's hand or gave somebody a hug or made them feel happy? How about that? Sound like a plan? Awesome. And let's have a prayer, okay? Something we don't have to like hold hands or anything, but we could be in the spirit of prayer, maybe close our eyes and bow our heads and put our hands together. Holy gracious God, we are thankful for this day and we are thankful for the 525,600 minutes that have happened in the last year, but help us to count the hugs, count the laughter, count the tears, count all the times that we lifted each other up and helped each other grow and made each other happy. Help us to focus on that instead of just the minutes. And we ask all these things in Jesus' name, amen. Thanks, you guys. Have fun at Sunday school. Going on, please.
Let us prepare ourselves to hear the word of God by being in an attitude of prayer. Holy God, source of all light, by your word you give light to the soul. Pour out upon us the spirit of wisdom and understanding, that being taught by you in Holy Scripture, our hearts and minds may be open to know the things that lead to light. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. This morning, our Broadway journey brings us to the 1990s New York City. The characters in Rent are all struggling to make ends meet, and many of them are also navigating life with HIV when treatments were still mostly experimental and survival rates were not guaranteed. Jesus' followers knew those struggles as well, and Jesus gave them something to think about as they also lived lives with uncertain futures. He said to his disciples, "Therefore, I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat, or about your body, what you will wear. For life is more than food, and the body more than clothing. Consider the ravens. They neither sow nor reap. They have neither storehouse nor barn, and yet God feeds them. Oh, how much more value are you than the birds? And can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to the span of your life? If then you are not able to do so small a thing as that, why do you worry about the rest? Consider the lilies, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. Yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which is alive today and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, how much more will he clothe you, you of little faith? And do not keep striving for what you are to eat and what you are to drink, and do not keep worrying, for it is the nations of the world that strive after all these things, and your Father knows that you need them. Instead, strive for his kingdom, and these things will be given to you as well." This is the word of the Lord. Give thanks to God.
Will you pray with me? Spirit of the living God, come fresh on me. Spirit of the living God, come fresh on me. Amen. So last Friday, while I was at Music on the Green and we were getting set up, I was talking to one of the musicians and they were supposed to play last year, but they got rained out. And so we were talking about the difference between last year and this year. And he was like, "Was that a whole year ago?" Yes. Yes, it was. Time has felt so fluid since this pandemic hit 2 years ago. What was supposed to be over in about 2 weeks became 2 months and then 6 months and then 2 years. And it's still not entirely behind us. Rituals and occasions that help us mark time were canceled, postponed, or greatly modified, like weddings or graduations or funerals. In church life, we have several seasons. One half of the year is full of the focus on Jesus' birth, life, death, and resurrection in Advent, Epiphany, Lent, and Easter. And then in the second half, which we call ordinary time, which is what we're in now, we think about more like what it means for our daily lives. What is all this stuff? What are we supposed to do? In secular life, we have four seasons: winter, spring, summer, fall, or maybe starting school, in school, end of school, and gearing back up for school to start. Does like the back to school season start earlier every year, or is it just me? Like, now it starts 2 weeks after they leave, right? Yeah, okay. The show Rent follows a group of hard luck friends in 1990s New York City through a full calendar year from Christmas Eve to the next Christmas Eve. And most of the characters in this ensemble piece are HIV positive, and one does develop full-blown AIDS. The two songs that we hear today, what we heard earlier, No Day But Today, and later we'll hear Seasons of Love, they both reflect on how we experience the passage of time and suggest better ways to do that. Seasons of Love reminds us to stop thinking about a year in the number of months or days or minutes or quarters, but to focus on the way love has broken through for us in daylights, in sunsets, at midnights, in cups of coffee, in laughter, in strife, in the ways we've loved, in the ways we've hurt, the ways we've been together, all the ways that make us feel truly alive, whether good times or rough times. In our scripture today, Jesus is preaching to crowds so big they trampled on one another. He's telling them they are important to God no matter how much money or how much stuff they have, and to let go of the yardsticks the authorities in society use to judge them, that God loves them more than anyone, and as such, God takes care of them more than the flowers in the field or the birds of the air. Can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your life? He asked them. In the show Rent, there are variations of the song No Day But Today that show up in several places in the show. And at the very end of the show, the lyrics say, there is no future, there is no past. You've got to make this moment last. Some of the scenes where the song shows up are support group meetings for people with HIV. The show takes place at the height of the AIDS crisis, where getting a diagnosis could still mean a death sentence. And in one of those group sessions, someone sings, will I lose my dignity? Will someone care? Will I wake tomorrow from this nightmare? The folks in that crowd Jesus preached to were in a similar place. They were day laborers, widows, orphans, and not really sure where the next meal was going to come from. People on the margins and are just scraping by. They probably asked those same questions. Will I lose my dignity? Will someone care? Will I wake tomorrow from this nightmare? And Jesus tells them, look at the lilies. They don't work. They don't do chores. And yet they are more beautiful than anything even King Solomon could have put together. Look at the ravens. Here in Northwest Connecticut, maybe we could think about crows. They don't plant, they don't reap, but they always have enough to eat. God takes care of them, and God loves you way more than crows. In a way, Jesus is telling this crowd what Rent is saying in these two songs as well. Don't dwell in the past, don't live in the future, don't focus on the calendar, be here now. Don't focus on the task list, be here now. Focus on love, where we receive it, and also where we share it. Rent opened off-Broadway in early 1996, and tragically, its author, Jonathan Larson, died unexpectedly the night before. It opened on Broadway 4 months later and ended up winning 4 Tony Awards, including Best Musical. It took a new look at the opera La Boheme and placed it in New York City's East Village, telling the story of 8 friends doing the best they can in life and love with little resources. The song No Day But Today became an anthem for me in 2000 when I heard a men's choir sing it at this giant choir event, because the power of letting go of all that baggage we carry with us to actually live in this moment is huge. Being attentive right here and right now is huge, because really, that's all we have. It's all we ever have, is right here and right now. And that was Jesus' message as well. Don't carry around the baggage piled on by the religious authorities, because in a lot of cases, they are projecting their own prejudices and biases onto others, and that hasn't changed either. That was Jesus' message. Don't focus on acquiring vast amounts of wealth or stuff, because either it can all go away, or we can die before we're able to enjoy it. Jonathan Larson spent years creating this show and died the night before it opened, never knowing the success that it would bring. While Jesus spoke these words millennia ago, they still hold true. Earlier in this part of Luke, Jesus says, "Beware the hypocrisy of the Pharisees. There is nothing secret that will not be made known." You might want to think about that in our present day as well. The Pharisees, the religious authorities, they could get really judgy, as we all can on occasion. But when we get caught up in the judginess, either the judginess of others who aren't doing it our way, or judginess of ourselves that we aren't good enough, what can we do to turn that off? The Pharisees might have had one answer, but Jesus says, consider the lilies. Remember the ravens. reground and reset and remember, there is no day but today. Remember to stop measuring in minutes or completed tasks or dollars made, but to measure in love. Even thinking about coming to church on a random Sunday changes the calculus to focus on love, not the time commitment of coming to church or our to-do list as ushers or readers or deacons. Pastor Jerry Herships, a Methodist minister in Colorado, posted on Facebook a while back, when you're trying to decide on any given Sunday about whether to come to church or not, don't think about whether you'll like the music or the sermon. Come because there's someone there that needs you to love them. Come because someone there needs you. How do we measure a year in the life? In rituals, in weather patterns, in school years? While those are helpful, let's measure in love, in the support we give each other, in the shared laughter, in the shared tears, in the shared sword muscles after the green fair, in the inspiration from great music, in the hugs, in the high fives, and mostly in the knowledge that we loved someone while we were here. Someone needs you to love them today in your specific way that nobody else can give them. The characters in Rent were there for each other, some at the very end of their lives, some at what seemed like the very end. They made it so they all had dignity. They all knew they were cared for, that even if the nightmare didn't end, there were others experiencing it with them, holding them up and loving them. What can you measure in love today? Amen. Let's rise in body or spirit and join together in singing our next hymn, which should be on an insert.
Thank you.
Please be seated. One of the ways we measure in love is how we share our lives with each other. I mean, that's the nugget. That is the thing. And so now is the time where we share our joys and concerns with each other so that we can lift each other up, so that we can share that love that we all need. So what joys and concerns do you have this day? Like Judy said, we want to lift Carol in prayer and she's not feeling well. So God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Go ahead.
Traveling mercies to Andrew, who is somewhere out in the Pacific. He went to Pearl Harbor on Wednesday and took an Osprey out to an aircraft carrier somewhere for 10 days. So prayer is a great experience.
So prayers for Andrew as he is on his next adventure with the U.S. Navy out somewhere in the Pacific on an aircraft carrier. He went out to Pearl Harbor and now he's living the Navy life for a couple weeks. So travel mercies for him while he's there and as he comes, and that he comes back safely. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Go ahead. So keeping Will May, who I guess passed away recently, his service was just recently, and so keeping his family and friends in prayer, where they did a song at his service from Footloose, because why not? God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Good. I hear those first year birthday parties can be brutal. I don't know what that's about, but it's true. So congratulations for making one. And I have a special relationship with, what is her name? Hattie. Because Hattie's parents were out on the green last summer before Hattie was born. So I would say I knew Hattie before when she was negative days old. So that she's a year old. Again, how is it a year already? But congratulations and mazel tov. God in your mercy, hear our prayer. Go ahead, Dick. Absolutely, continued prayers for the people of Ukraine. God in your mercy, hear our prayer. Anybody in the chat box, David? Go ahead. So grateful for the world premiere of Anna Green Gables at, where was it? Goodspeed Opera House. So there's a testimony. Apparently, if you want to go see it, go see it. But good art is always a blessing. And so that is how to measure in love. Absolutely. So for gratitude of the arts, God in your mercy, hear our prayer. Amen. Concern for those who don't have air conditioning in these unprecedentedly hot times. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Shop, So gratitude for the state of Connecticut for allowing free admission to the museums across the state, which is a good way to get out of the heat, just saying. So they got to have a great time out in Mystic at that museum up there. So if you have a chance and you have some time, by all means, take advantage. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You are? So prayers for a new opportunity, that it goes well and it's successful. A banker? Oh, congratulations. Awesome. So God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Go ahead. Hopefully I'll get all that. So prayers. Please. So for AFS means American Field Service opportunities. Yeah. So exchange students for 60 years ago, Trish's mom met somebody from Belgium, and now the Belgian friend's kids are with Trish's sister, and the grandkids are all together. And that's how it works, right? Peace through hanging out. So that's exciting. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. I had another one and it's gone. Well, God hears all our prayers. If there are nothing else, let us be in a spirit of prayer. O Lord, hear our prayer. O Lord, hear our prayer. When I call, answer me. O Lord, hear our prayer. O Lord, hear our prayer. Come and listen to me. Holy, gracious, and loving God, we are once again thankful for this day. We are grateful for all your many blessings and all the ways that you have shown us love. Help us to hear that and help us to know that you hear all our petitions, whether out loud or in the silence of our hearts. And we ask all these things in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. So we have just a few announcements this morning. Right on time. Our final Music on the Green is this Friday at 6:30, Ron Castanway from the Gun School is gonna be playing his saxophone. He was amazing last year. I expect nothing less this year. So if you're not doing anything Friday night, 6:30, bring your blanket or your chairs, coming out. It's been great this year. And if you wanna get some food from the Poe, by all means, order that ahead. But this has been a super successful year with Music on the Green. I think it's grown. And so hopefully next year it'll be even better. So come join us Friday at 6:30 for that. Apparently the Washington Friends of Music concerts are postponed. There's some issues going on there, but stay tuned at their website to see if those do come back at some point. And like we mentioned last week, there is a new mental health resource. You can dial 988. It's like 911, but it's for mental health and suicide prevention. So if you are having a rough time, or if you know somebody who's having a rough time, have them call 988 and someone will talk to them and help them get through that time. And then keep those food donations coming for our New Milford and Washington Warren food banks. There are people who are food insecure in our communities, and so we can help them. So when you're out shopping, just grab a couple items, drop it off in the parish house at the door, and you'll be good to go. Because it is important to keep helping our neighbors. Both our flowers and our steeple lighting this week are given by Tamara Sachs and Margot Janowitz in loving memory of Dr. Joe Janowitz. And so we thank them for that. We are just grateful. I mean, it's a little bit of a slow time. The green fair is over, but we are so grateful that you all come and you show up and you share your love. And we just ask that you can share your gifts as well. We do have boxes in the back if you want to drop in a check or some cash that way, or you can always give online, or you can go through the website and go that way, or you can just mail a check. But whatever works for you, we are so grateful that you can share out of your abundance, because we are an important voice here in this time and in this place. And so we thank you.
Thank you.
Let's be in a spirit of prayer. Holy, gracious, and loving God, we thank you for the gifts that we have received from you, and we are grateful that we can share from our abundance to help you do your work here in this time, in this place, and in these next 525,600 minutes. We are so grateful, and we thank you and praise you for all our many gifts. Amen. So please remain standing as you are able, and let's join together in our final hymn. I just want to say a word of thanks for Elizabeth Kirby. I hope I said your name right. For filling in for Jesse today, who's on a much deserved vacation, and also to our wonderful friend Caitlin, who is, it's always such a blessing when she shares her voice with us. And so we thank you so much for being with us today. And so, friends, let us leave here with open hearts to share God's unconditional love with all we meet. We will go with courage, holding fast to what is good, rendering to no one evil for evil. We will strengthen the faint-hearted, support the weak, and help the afflicted. Honoring all beings, we will serve God, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. And so, friends, hear these words of benediction. There is only us. There is only this. Forget regret, or life is ours to miss. no other road, no other way. There is no day but today to live the gospel as best we can, sharing the love of God in Christ and through the Holy Spirit as we go out into the world. Amen. If everyone's interested, there is some light refreshments in the entrance to the parish house.